Hello students, welcome in maths. Dear students, in this season we are going to discuss some important topic in your 8th maths, which is not important for this year but also important for your next standard. Okay, so dear student, let's start the topic number 10, division of polynomials. Student, in previous class you have studied the addition, subtraction, multiplication of algebraic expression. Okay, let's recall these expressions again. Okay, see these examples. First example is 2a plus 3a. We have to first add this number 2 plus 3, that is 5, and a means 2a plus 3a is equal to 5a. This is the addition of algebraic expression. Next example is 7b minus 4b. In this algebraic expression, we have to subtract 7 minus 4. 7 minus 4 is 3. And b variable is written as it is. The answer is 3b. Now, we have to multiply this algebraic expression. 5 into 3, that is 15. Okay, m variable written as it is, m square into m square, that is m raised to 4. Okay, according to rule of index. Okay, let's see this example again. 2a plus 3a is equal to 5a. We add the number first and variable is written as it is, means 2a plus 3a is 5a. 7b minus 4b is equal to 3b. In this example, we have to subtract 7 minus 4. Answer is 3b. And next example, we have to multiply this number. 5 minus 3 is equal to 15. M is written as it is, and m square into m square is equal to m raised to 4. Okay, this kind of example we have to solve in last year. Okay. In this topic, we have to discuss about what is mean by polynomial. Let's discuss about this. Then, what is mean by polynomials? Generally, algebraic expressions are divided into different parts, that is monomial, binomials and trinomials. Okay? The expression having more than one variables, this expression is known as a polynomials. In these polynomials, okay, let's discuss, see this example. Example number first is x square plus 2x plus 3. This is polynomials. And second example is 3y cube plus 2y square plus y plus 5. These both examples are polynomials. Because in these examples, the more than two monomials are present. Okay, so therefore these both examples are polynomials. Okay, also one important note is the index of this algebraic expression are in whole number. Okay, look at this, the index of x is 2, 2 is a whole number, and index of y is 3, and index of 2y is 2. These all index of algebraic expressions are in whole number. This kind of algebraic expression is known as a polynomial. Okay, you have to remember that the polynomials having more than two monomials, and the index of these algebraic expressions are always in a whole number. This kind of algebraic expression is known as a polynomials. These are the examples of polynomials. So student, let's discuss one more important point, that is degree of polynomials. Okay students, I have written two examples in blackboard. With the help of this example, we have to identify degree of polynomials. First example is x cube plus 2x square plus 3 plus 2. And second example is x raised to 4 plus x raised to 5 plus 3x plus 1. In these both example, both are the polynomials and having index in a whole number. We have to identify degree of the polynomial. Then what is mean by degree of the polynomial? In the given algebraic expression, the biggest index of this algebraic expression is known as the degree of polynomial. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, डिग्री ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल म्हणजे काय? दिलेल्या अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन मधला सर्वात मोठा घातांक जो असतो तो त्या अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशनचा काय असतो? डिग्री ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल असतो. देन हाऊ टू राईट आन्सर? लुक ॲट द फर्स्ट एक्झाम्पल, एक्स क्यूब प्लस टू एक्स स्क्वेअर प्लस थ्री प्लस टू. इन दॅट टू इंडेक्स आर प्रेझेंट, एक्स रेस टू थ्री अँड एक्स रेस टू टू. इन दॅट द एक्स रेस टू थ्री is the highest degree of this algebraic expression or biggest degree of this algebraic expression. So the degree of this first algebraic expression or polynomial is 3. Okay, let's write the answer. Degree of polynomial is equal to 3 because 3 is the highest degree of algebraic expression. Okay, let's solve the next example. Okay, in the next algebraic expression, x raised to 4 plus x raised to 5 plus 3x plus 1. In this polynomial, the highest degree is 5. Okay, therefore, 5 is the degree of the given polynomial. Dear student, all of you remember this point carefully because this degree of polynomial is also important for your 9th standard. Okay, let's see again. The degree of polynomial is nothing but the highest index of the given polynomial or highest index of the given algebraic expression. So student, let's solve some more example related to the polynomials. In that, we first discuss about the divide the monomial by monomial. Okay, let's solve this example. Point is to divide a monomial by a monomial. Let's solve an example. 15p cube divided by 3p. Okay, in that example, one monomial divide with another monomial. In the monomial, only single terms are present. Okay. 15p cube is a monomial and 3p is a next monomial. We divide one monomial by another monomial. Okay, let's write this in the division form. 15p cube divided by 3p. Okay, in that example, we have to first multiply 3 into 5. The multiplication will be 15. Okay. 3, 5 is 15. Then for getting p cube, how many p requires for this multiplication form? Let's calculate this. That is, okay. p into p square is equal to p raised to 3 or p cube. Okay, look at this multiplication. For getting 15p cube answer, we have to multiply 3p with 5p square, and this multiplication will be 15p cube. So our question is 5p square and answer will be 15p cube. For subtraction of these, our remainder is 0 and our final answer is 5p square. Because for multiplying 3p into 5p square, we are getting 15p cube. या उदाहरणामध्ये विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, भागाकार करत असताना तुम्हाला गुणाकार येणंही आवश्यक आहे. मग काय करायचं आहे नेमकं? 3p ज्याला भागायचं आहे त्याला किती न गुणलं की उत्तर 15 पी चा घन येईल हे शोधायचं आहे आपण.
ते आपण एक्सप्लेनेशन मध्ये लिहिणार आहोत. व 3p ला 5p वर्ग ने गुणल्यानंतर आपल्याला उत्तर किती मिळतं, 15p चा घन. त्यामुळे भाग कितीचा जाणार आहे, तर 5p चा वर्ग ने भाग जाणार आहे. मग 5p चा वर्ग उत्तर किती येणार आहे, मल्टिप्लिकेशन करून 15p चा घन, आणि बाकी किती उरणार आहे, 0. त्यामुळे उत्तर काय आलं, 5p2. ओके, लेट्स सॉल्व द नेक्स्ट एक्झाम्पल. नेक्स्ट एक्झाम्पल इज 21p³ - 7p. लेट्स राईट दिस एक्झाम्पल इन डिव्हिजन फॉर्म, 20p³ / 7p. लेट्स फाइंड आउट द 7p इनटू व्हिच नंबर व्हिच आर गेटिंग आंसर 21p³. ओके, 7p ला कशाने गुणल्यानंतर उत्तर 21p चा घन मिळणार आहे हे आपण शोधणार आहोत. तर 7 ला 7 × 3 दॅट इज 7 × 3 = 21. हियर पी इज प्रेझेंट हॅव्हिंग 1 इंडेक्स, सो वी हॅव टू रिटन p² p² = p³ अकॉर्डिंग टू रूल ऑफ इंडेक्स. जर पी ला पी च्या वर्ग गुणलं तर आपलं उत्तर किती येणार आहे, पी चा घन. घातांकाचे नियम तुम्ही शिकलेला आहात, इथं पी म्हणजे घातांक 1 असतो, पी चा वर्ग. मग पाया समान असेल तर घातांकांची बेरीज होते. उदाहरणार्थ पी चा पहिला घात आहे गुणिले पी चा दुसरा घात आहे. पाया समान असेल तर घातांकांची काय होते, बेरीज होते. म्हणजे उत्तर काय आलं, आलं आपलं पी चा घन. सो आवर आन्सर इज 3p² - 21p³. रिमाइंडर इज 0 एंड अवर फाइनल आंसर इज 3p². ओके, दिस इज अवर फाइनल आंसर. ओके, दिस इज अ वेरी इजी एक्झाम्पल. यू हॅव टू कम्पेअर बोथ एक्झाम्पल एंड मल्टिप्लिकेशन इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर सॉल्विंग डिव्हिजन. ओके, देन सी द नेक्स्ट एक्झाम्पल हॅव्हिंग अ निगेटिव्ह नंबर दॅट इज 48q. Divided by -10a. Okay, this example is little bit different because in that the one number is positive and another number is negative. Let's solve this example. 48q divided by -10a. Okay, then -10a into which number we have to multiply this for getting answer 48q. Okay, वजा 10a ला कितीने गुणायला पाहिजे की जेणेकरून आपलं उत्तर 40a चा गुण येईल. ओके, देन 10 × 4 = 40. ओके, हियर a इज प्रेझेंट अँड हियर a क्यूब इज प्रेझेंट, सो देअरफोर हियर वी हॅव टू रिटर्न a² ओके, सो हियर द नंबर इज पॉझिटिव्ह अँड ऑल्सो देअरफोर फॉर गेटिंग पॉझिटिव्ह अँसर दिस विल बी निगेटिव्ह. ओके, 10 × 4 = 40, a² = a³ अँड मायनस मीन्स बोथ निगेटिव्ह नंबर्स आर गेटिंग पॉझिटिव्ह नंबर. मीन्स -10 × -4 आन्सर इज +40. द पॉझिटिव्ह नंबर डज नॉट रिटर्न. ओके, सो फायनल आन्सर इज 40a³ अँड अवर आन्सर इज -4a² -4a² देन 40a³ अवर रिमाइंडर इज 0 and final answer is -4a². Okay, -4a². Student, hope you understand this example. We have to practice more example in your home. Let's see the next point. that is to divide polynomial by a monomial.
Come to the next point. Now we divide a polynomial by a monomial. Polynomials which have more than two terms and monomials have a single term. Look at this example. The example number first is 6x cube plus 8x square divided by 2x. Okay, in that 6x cube plus 8x square is a polynomial and 2x is a monomial. In that we have to divide the polynomial by a monomial. Okay, let's solve this example. First we have to write a polynomial, that is 6x cube plus 8x square divided by 2x. First you have to calculate 2x divided by 6x cube. Okay, in that the 2x into which number in the box present for getting answer 6x cube. Okay, let's find out. 2 3 6. Okay, 2 3 6. Here x cube is present, so therefore x into x square we are getting answer x cube. Okay, so our question is 3x square. When we have to multiply 2x into 3x square, we have getting answer 6x cube. So our question is 3x square. 3x square. And our answer will be 6x cube. The 6x cube minus 6x cube, the remainder is 0. Here the plus sign is present, so we have to write the plus sign in a question. And in this, the below the next number have to written as it is, that is 8x square. So again find out the question. Okay, in 2x into which number multiply for getting 8x square. Okay, let's find out this. 2 4 are 8. For getting x square, we have to multiply x by x. So x into x, we are getting answer x square. Our question is 4x. Then 2x into 4x is equal to 8x square. So we have to divide. 4x is our question, and 2x into 4x, and answer is 8x square. Okay, for subtraction of these we are getting 0. Then our final answer, that is question E, 3x square plus 4x, and remainder is 0. Okay, let's see this example again. In this example we have to divide polynomial by a monomial. 6x cube plus 8x square is a polynomial and 2x is a monomial. Let's write this example in a division form, that is 6x cube plus 8x square divided by 2x. We have to find out the question. Okay, 2x into 3x square, we are getting answer 6x cube. So our first question is 3x square. Then multiplication is 6x cube. 6x cube minus 6x cube is 0. Then remaining number is 8x square written as it is. The plus sign is given in front of the question. Then 2x into 4x is equal to 8x square. So the next question is 4x. 2x into 4x is equal to 8x square, and 8x square minus 8x square, the remainder is 0. And our final answer is, question is 3x square plus 4x, and remainder is 0. Okay, let's solve the more examples.
Let's solve the next example.
The example is 5x cube minus 3x square divided by x square. Here 5x cube minus 3x square is a polynomial and x square is a monomial. Let's write this example in division form. 5x cube minus 3x square divided by x square. Okay, let's again find out the number. X square into which number here present for getting answer 5x cube. Okay, in the x square which number we have to multiply this for getting answer 5x square. Okay, first here 5 is present because 5 into x getting 5x answer. For getting index x we have written here 5x. Because x square into x answer is x cube. So our question is 5x. Multiplication of x square into 5x is equal to 5x cube. 5x cube. Subtraction of 5x cube into 5x cube remainder is 0. Here minus sign are present, so we have to write minus sign in front of the 5x. The next number is minus 6x square. In this example, x square into which number present in the box for getting answer minus 3x square. Okay, x square into which number here present for getting answer minus 3x square. Let's find out. Here 3 is present because 3 into 1 is equal to 3. Okay, next is x square. So here present x. X okay into x. So our answer is x square or only here present 3. Okay, so negative number is present, so therefore here negative sign is present. Okay, x into minus 3, minus 3, and x square present as it is. So our question is minus 3. We are getting answer minus 3x square. Okay, here get positive. Okay, 3x square minus 3x square remainder is 0. Then our final question is 5x minus 3 and remainder is 0. Okay, let's see this example again. In this example, we have to write 5x cube minus 3x square divided by x square. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, या उदाहरणामध्ये x वर्गला किती न गुणलं की उत्तर 5x का गुण येतो हे आपल्याला शोधायचं आहे. मग x वर्गला 5x ने गुणलं की आपलं उत्तर येतं 5x चा गुण. आता इथं x चा वर्ग आहे, इथं 1 असतो व्हेरिएबल त्याचा. मग 1 गुणिले 5 5 आणि इथं x लिहिल्यामुळे x चा वर्ग गुणिले x चा घातांकांची बेरीज झाल्यानंतर त्याचं उत्तर येईल x चा घन. त्यानंतर म्हणजे आपलं पहिलं उत्तर काय आलं 5x. 5x ला x वर्ग गुणलं की आपलं उत्तर किती येणार आहे 5x चा घन. 5x चा घन म्हणून 5x घन केलं, बाकी किती उरणार आहे 0. मग पुढचा मोनोमियल आपण उतरून घेतला 3x चा वर्ग. आता इथं जे आहे वजा चिन्ह आहे, त्यामुळे x वर्गला अशा संख्येने गुणायचं आहे की येणार उत्तरच आपलं निगेटिव्ह मध्ये आलं पाहिजे, म्हणजे मायनस 3x स्क्वेअर आलं पाहिजे. मग त्यासाठी मायनस 3, मायनस 3 इंटू एक्स स्क्वेअर इज इक्वल टू मायनस 3x स्क्वेअर. ओके, द क्वेश्चन इज मायनस 3. मग वजा 3x चा वर्ग, वजा 3x चा वर्ग, इथं वजा बाकी असल्यामुळं शेवटच्या याच्या टर्म्सचं चिन्ह बदलतात, वजाचा अधिक झालं. मग अधिक वजा आपण काय करतो, वजा बाकी. तीन एक्स वर्ग मधून 3x वर्ग गेले, राहिले किती 0. मग आपलं उत्तर काय आलं 5x मायनस 3. ओके, लेट्स सॉल्व वन मोर एक्झाम्पल अगेन.
Look at the next example. The example is 3y cube plus 4y square plus 3 divided by 2y square. Here 2y cube plus 4y square plus 3 is a polynomial and 2y square is a monomial. Let's start to divide this. Okay, 2y square into which number for getting answer 2y cube. Okay, for getting answer 2y cube. In this example, 2y square into which number we are to put in this box for getting answer 2y cube. Here, we have to multiply 2y square by y. So, our final answer is 2y cube. Okay. Y into 2y. Y square into y, that is y cube. So, question is y. Then, 2y square into y, we are getting answer 2y cube. 2y square, 2y cube minus 2y cube, remainder is 0. Next number is 4y square. Here plus sign is present. Okay. 2y square into which number present in the box for getting answer 4y square. Okay. We have to multiply 2 by 2, then 2 to the 4. Okay, here y square is already present, so therefore the quotient is only 2. Then 2y square into 2, we are getting answer 4y square. Our quotient is 2. We are getting answer 4y square. Okay, then subtraction 4y square minus 4y square, getting remainder is 0. And next number is plus 3, return as 18. Okay, in that 2y square is divided by 3 is not getting an answer because it is, this number is not the algebraic expression. So, remainder is 3. Then what will be the final answer? Our question is y plus 2 and remainder is 3. Okay, या उदाहरणामध्ये विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो सुरुवातीला आपण 2y वर्गला y ने गुणले की आपलं उत्तर किती आलं आहे 2y चा घन. मग 2y चा घन वजा 2y चा घन केले की आपली बाकी किती होते 0. त्यानंतर दुसरा फॅक्टर आपण उतरून घेतला 4y चा वर्ग. मग 2y वर्गला 2 ने गुणले की आपलं उत्तर किती येते 4y चा वर्ग. मग आपला भागाकार किती ने भाग घालणार आपण 2 ने. मग 4y वर्ग गुणिले 4y वर्ग बाकी किती आली 0. त्यानंतर आणखीन एक अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन मध्ये आणखीन एक लास्ट नंबर राहतो 3. आता 2y वर्ग न 3 ला भाग जात नाही. भाग जात नसल्यामुळे रिमाइंडर आपला बाकी किती उरणार आहे 3. आणि फायनल आंसर काय क्वेश्चन y अधिक 2 आणि रिमाइंडर किती आला 3. डियर स्टुडंट होप यू अंडरस्टँड दिस एक्झाम्पल. होप यू अंडरस्टँड ऑल दिस एक्झाम्पल वी हॅव टू सॉल्व इन दिस व्हिडिओ. टुडे we have to study about the introduction to polynomial. The remember one thing is that the index of the algebraic expression is always in a whole number and this is known as a polynomial. Second point we have to discuss about the degree of polynomials. In the given polynomials, the highest index of the polynomial is known as the degree of that polynomial. We have to also solve some example related to this. This is important for your next standard also. Next point is to divide a monomial by a monomial. And next is to divide polynomial by a monomial. Today we have to discuss these whole points and solving examples related to this. Okay, these whole examples is also important for your next standard. For more practice, all of you solve the practice set 10.1 in your notebook. Okay, see you in next video with next point. Thank you.